information on what to do with your crisis. Now, it was found out that one of your employees dragged pizza dough across the kitchen floor. Now, you guys previously knew about it, but you didn't realize that someone recorded it and posted it to YouTube. You already handled the situation, but now it's out in the public, and you guys are a family-owned business, and you're not as big as other public restaurants, so you want to keep your customers with you. It's not easy to, like, get your reputation back again after this comes out. So, I have put together a thing to tell you how to handle your situation. First things first is communication. It's very important that you communicate with your public, your customers, because they're all that you have, because you're a family-owned business. You don't have big social media and the news people looking at you or anything like that, because you're a family-owned business. So you want to communicate with them that your restaurant is never run this way, that it was one instance and that you took care of the situation right after it happened, that no one made pizza with the pizza dough that was dragged across the floor or anything like that. So it's very important that you communicate with your customers, as they're the biggest stakeholders in your business. Next thing is honesty. You want to be honest with them and tell them that, hey, yeah, you knew about it, that that it wasn't made up, that you did take care of it. So my recommendation is to post a thing on your website stating what happened and how you knew about it, and how anyone that comes into your restaurant becomes a part of your family, that you do not treat your family members the way that your employees were, that they're very important to you, and you're going to explain it on your website because you guys aren't that big of a business because you're a family-owned restaurant. So you have to be upfront and honest with them and admit that it happened. Don't pretend that it didn't, because you knew it happened. You fired the employees, so you have to let them know that it actually did happen, that you're sorry and that will never happen again, and everything like that, to get them to keep coming to your restaurant. Next thing is timeliness. You don't want to wait too long because you already knew about it. So since now we found out there was a video made and it was posted to everyone and everyone's seen it, you want to answer it very quickly, because if you wait too long and then say that you've known about it happening, then it looks kind of weird and fishy because you guys waited so long to respond to it, but you're telling them that you've known about it since it happened. So you want to say it, you want to talk to them right away, so you keep them coming back and hopefully get more business and you don't lose all your customers. But it's very important to keep coming back, because like I said, they're the only like people that you have. You don't have big news people looking at you, or you know, big social media or big customers coming in, because you guys are just a community restaurant. So you want to keep the community coming back and make sure you don't lose them, because once you lose them, that's it for your business, because you don't have a chain of restaurants. It's just this one business and you want to keep them coming back. This logo you guys have posted on your restaurant wall, you want to make sure that is very important to them, to make sure that they know that you do stand by this statement, that whoever eats at your restaurant is a part of your family, because this restaurant is like your second home. You know, you have your brothers running the restaurant and your mother and your father and all that running the restaurant. So you want to make sure that they know that when they eat there, they're going to be treated like a part of your family, that they're not just another customer, that they are very important to you. So again, we went through the three important things: communication, timeliness, and honesty. If you are not doing any of those things, you could be shut down, because you're not going to have anyone coming and eating at your place anymore.